Alright guys, we're back in my garage for another video. If you're new to the channel, I use these videos to help keep you updated on the latest developments related to our cars, as well as discuss technical topics so that we have a better understanding of how our engines work. If that's something that you're interested in, be sure to subscribe to the channel. There will be a lot more of these videos coming out in the future. So today we're going to be talking about high pressure fuel pumps again, and I'm just going to try to tackle a specific topic because a lot of people ask me how they can know if their high pressure fuel pump is working. And I know there's a little bit of confusion about what to expect after you swap high pressure fuel pumps. And when you run logs, maybe you're not seeing the difference that you expect. And so there are, of course, a lot of explanations on why this is. And I think it's a little bit more simple than people realize. So the easiest way that I try to describe it is to think about a turbo. A lot of people know that if you're on the stock turbo at 20 PSI, for example, you're going to make less power than you would on a big turbo at 20 PSI. And that's because the bigger turbo is able to flow more air. So the increased flow is what supports more power, not necessarily the pressure. The exact same thing works with our fuel system. So I know a lot of people get confused because they install a TU pump or a Dorch Stage 2, and they're still seeing the same 200 bar or 2900 PSI. So they're not sure if their fuel pump is working. And the fact of the matter is the fuel pressure is controlled by the DME, and that is something completely separate from fuel flow. A higher flowing fuel pump can flow more fuel at the same pressure. And you don't necessarily want to run a lot more pressure because you can damage other components, particularly your injectors that aren't designed to handle more pressure. So that's why your pressure doesn't change. That's why you're not going to necessarily see more fuel flow in your logs. You're also not necessarily going to see more boost or even more power just by installing a high pressure fuel pump. Everything that's controlled by the DME is going to monitor how much fuel is being delivered into the engine. And if you have a fuel pump that can flow more fuel, it's going to dial back that setting so that it's flowing the same fuel as before. So you're going to need to tune your car in order to make more boost and make more power and take advantage of that higher flowing fuel pump. I know this is especially confusing for people that install the TU pump, because a lot of people are basically expecting it to run like a TU engine. So they're looking for it to say 5,000 PSI or 350 bar, and they think until it shows that much that there's something wrong with the fuel pump. But keep in mind, this is a mechanical component. It's not something that typically fails very easily. There is a fuel control valve on the side that's controlled electronically, but the pump itself is extremely reliable and basically just bolts on and works. Unfortunately, we don't have a lot of data in most of our logging software that directly tells us how much fuel is flowing to the engine. But what I tell most people is simply flash the tune that's designed for the fuel pump you're running. Or if you're running a custom tune, just begin working your way through revisions and bumping up boost pressure. Most tuners have good visibility to what to expect for different turbo and fuel pump setups, and they can tell you if the limit is lower than expected so that you can see what's going on. But yeah, hopefully that answers your question. Again, I know a lot of people are just like, how does it flow more fuel if it doesn't make more pressure? Because fuel pressure is the main thing that we talk about and the main thing that we see in logs. If we were able to see fuel flow or injector flow or anything else, that would be super telling to help us out. But unfortunately, we just don't really have that in most of our logging software. But that would be the best way to be able to tell how much fuel is flowing through the high pressure fuel pump to know that it's working. I just get a lot of questions from people saying it's not making more pressure. So how do I know it's working, or how can it make more power? And the main thing to understand is that pressure and volume or flow are two separate parameters. So you can make more pressure with the same flow. You can make more flow with the same pressure. Those are two things that are dependent on the fuel pump design itself. And that's how it works when it's actually installed on our cars. So yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope it helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do 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 do